Good day. It is currently April 30th, 2018. Thanks so much for subscribing to the channel. I very much appreciate it. And thank you for pressing the like button. And if you would like to, you can press the bell button if you'd like notifications of when I'm doing my videos. As you can see, I'm still in my nightie today. It's currently Monday. That's why. Laughter's really important, I think, if you want to succeed today. Lately, I've been talking a lot about laughter, and I've been feeling guided to doing a video on laughter. Can you laugh? And that's even, like, I feel like something was telling me, like, to wear my house coat and just be me. Now I'm dropping stuff all over the place. So I think it's really important. And doing unto others the way you would want to be, you know, treat people the way you would want to be treated, that sort of thing. I think it's really important. So making the conscious effort to be kind today is really important. Some people need more grounding than others. We can work with crystals and stones. I'm shortly going to be posting more for my jewelry stuff online. That's some of the stuff work I'm doing today. So if you're fascinated about anything right now, really pursue that. We're working on our dreams. So what really feeds your spirit? What can you learn? So working around the education system is really coming up. You're trying to find your path a little bit, I feel, today. So drawing, you know, like positive energy into your body is also important. So although it's important to be grounded, what are the positive things that we can do for our body, that our spiritual self, that will make us feel better? Maybe it is a meditation practice. Maybe it is like a nice salt bath or a massage, something like that, okay? But we want to give back to ourselves. Perhaps it is taking a course on something. Now, I also do some courses that may interest you, and you can check out robinshealing.com if you'd like to check out some of those. So we want to really pursue our dreams and those new avenues that we're trying to create, because last night we had our full moon, and for some people it's tonight as well. So we're still in a lot of that powerful energy. And if you feel like you're not as important as other people right now, you need to let go of that attitude, all right? It may be related to an ex, something that somebody said to you in your even past life, maybe, that you're still carrying some negative emotions and feelings around. So when we have these full moons, we're really clearing out the crap, okay? I can relate to that. I've been struggling with some things lately myself, and it's like I cannot let what that man said to me affect me, because if I do, that's just going to, like, you know, take away from my spirit. And I don't want things to take away from my spirit. I want things to add to my life, right? So it may be that if you're having any addiction right now at this time, that you're letting go of those old past behaviors and patterns. Again, just letting it all go, all right? And that's not easier said than done, but we're kind of like inching our way. I think we're just recognizing how things are affecting us and why they're affecting us. You may actually find that you have a little more mental strength at this moment to actually accomplish the things that you need, because we're always, we always have what we need in order to, like, deal or handle a situation. But that, talking about the past behaviors and stuff, sometimes it's learned, right? If you've been in a past relationship that's been very hurtful for you, and someone was really mean, then of course that's going to affect us now. And we still have what we need in order to handle and deal, like, with situations. But you may feel like that person took your ability away to, like, cope and deal with stress or something like that. So the way that you feel in your space, like who you're around and the things that are around you, are extremely important for your own sensitivity, all right? So we want to be mindful of who we're around, who we sleep with, that's coming up, and being honest with ourselves, all right? So, you know, if you feel like you're not a great person, I guess identifying with why you think that, perhaps you need to forgive yourself for past behaviors as well. Maybe you weren't nice to that person that wasn't nice to you. But forgive yourself for those things as well, because we can't, like, holding on to this junk is not helpful, all right, people? And that fear energy is really what needs to leave your body, all right? So when we're coming up with conclusions on situations and that sort of thing, we're acknowledging what we don't want, healing those situations, a lot of stuff's going to come up for you that's actually going to be really, like, relevant, I feel, and you're going to be like, you know what? I am good enough, or this is good enough, and I'm okay with this. So it's working on more peace and enlightenment and even some joy today. And I feel like if you miss someone in your life that you don't have, try not to focus on what you're missing or what you're lacking. Focus on what have I learned from this situation? What do I get to do now? All right, and that's going to bring you more into the present moment. So there is some selfish energy happening around. So make sure that you're not around selfish people. Or that you're being, like I said, kind to other people. Like, try to give to people the way that you would want people to give to you, all right? And don't hold any attachment to that. Like, just let go and trust in the universe today. Happy outcome, brilliant new ideas that lead to success. Have confidence in yourself. This sun, so this is the most optimistic card that we can have. It's about really accomplishing your dreams, or at least setting out to accomplish those dreams. Trust that there is success in front of you, and that you're walking towards more success, all right? So that's almost like the path of enlightenment, I feel like, for a lot of people. Then we have life experience, Archangel Shamuel, a significant life event, a powerful revelation that leads to change. I think revelation is the key word today. Time to spread your wings. So acknowledging what is it that is no longer serving us. Using our imaginations. Perhaps we need to get into that visual experience when we go into our meditation. What do we see? Is there inspiration on that path for us? Painting your walls, that sort of thing may change the way that you feel, all right? Just dive a little deeper into the things that make you happy. Go get into it. So for me, I was talking about working on my jewelry. I need to get excited about that. So I could think, like, I haven't opened up my drawer, actually. I have all these nice new beads to make bracelets. So it's like, maybe I should just start going through those and ask the universe which ones I need, which ones I'm attracted to, and really start making some jewelry, right? It's important that we do that. We have to, like, let go of everything else in the moment and just enjoy those simple little things. There'll always be things that we need to do, but we need to set our mind at ease today, all right? I hope that this is helpful for you guys. I'm kind of feeling like it's a very interesting day, and I feel like a lot of people need to hear this. So that revelation, new attitude sort of thing is really good. And if you need to investigate a little bit further into a situation, you don't feel like the time is right at this moment to move forward, just dive deep into it. That's what's coming up. Dive deep. Figure it out. Archangel Azrael, release. This is more about the creativity and the final decision. The end of a phase or situation, spiritual transformation, time to move on. This is around choices, right? Finding our path, navigating through. I'm really being told imagination's important today. So close your eyes. I'm seeing a heart. And see what you can find energetically when you close your eyes. Do you see anything? I'm seeing lines all over the place too, like a grid. And that's all just like energy. So for me, I'm already feeling like, again, working from that heart today. What feeds my heart? What feeds my spirit? So you do the same practices, all right? The lovers, music may be really important for some people today. Archangel Raphael, intimate relationships, carefully weigh your decisions, good help. Signing agreements is coming through really strongly. Maybe it's about being in a position of authority or working with other people that are in a position of authority. Exposing people is coming up. Releasing that idea, I think, is important too, to like just trust that your life is going to go in the direction that that it needs to, and we don't need to explode or exploit people. We just need to create more peace rather than war. That's really coming through, that could relate to me as well, because I've been having an experience with somebody, and I kind of thought, well, should I be sharing this? Should I share this with people? I know it's not going to look great on that person's favor, but is it worth sharing? And so I think it's like acknowledging that it's finding peace, right? It's not about it's about finding happiness within ourselves about situations as well. So making sure that we're happy about the situation is most important, all right? It's not about other people as much as it is about us and how we feel, all right? Very important. That's about learning from other people as well. I feel like it's good to go to a counselor. It's good to like come to me for a healing session. Really working more like out in the public with people that can help you. On May 17th, I'm also doing a how to read angel cards class from 6 to 8 in Moncton if you live in the local area. And then just working around the bank is coming up as well. So maybe there are things that you need to do around the bank, or you work at the bank, that's coming through. And then a book signing is also coming up, like a release around that. So again, I've been talking a lot about continuing to write my own book. So, just dive a little deeper into that. That's what I keep hearing. Dive deeper. All right. Seven of Water, a complex decision, the need to do research, stop procrastinating. I love this card. I'm loving it. So if you're clairvoyant, that would be a great card for you. If you need to release any anger, this is a great card for you. What are you diving deeper into? Is there judgment around you? Are you judging other people? Perhaps you're diving into your spiritual experience and you need to just talk to other people about that. You need to share those experiences with people, again, to find peace. That makes more sense. That's what I'm getting from my situation as well. You're diving deeper into it with other people to find more peace. That's relevant, all right? I like that. So if there's criticism or you're criticizing, that's not the point. It's about finding peace, all right? Gathering some thoughts and ideas together to get a hold of things before it becomes something more than what it is, all right? Because we want to create more love and light in the world. We don't want to allow people to continue their destructive behaviors. And I think it's like being old fashioned too is coming up. It's okay to like still love old music. It's okay to still think in old fashioned ways, because there's a lot of like peace around that. There's nothing wrong with like keeping some old patterns of behaviors that are positive. So we're not completely like letting go of who we are. We're embracing the aspects of ourselves that are really peaceful and powerful as well. So we're walking into our power. Ooh, I love these cards. Yeah, I'm like loving this. Daydream, you will more easily hear and receive our messages if you daydream regularly. Relax and open your mind to receiving without directing your thoughts. Just notice any feelings, visions, or ideas as if you were watching a movie. This is a seat of creativity. Very soothing. So something's coming up from the past and we're just letting it go, all right? So allow yourself to abandon those aspects of ourselves that, regardless of if we feel justified in the way that we were or the way that other people were, it's okay to kind of like leave the past behind, all right? So diving deeper into that. So it could be that ego likes to come up, that sort of thing. So just acknowledge that we need to get out of that, because ego is the opposite of intuition, right? So we want to dive deeper into the intuition and hear what's calling us, because I think it's about talking about war and peace a little bit. It's about people thinking like, oh, they need a taste of their own medicine type of thing. Well, that's not a positive way of looking at things. It's about diving deeper into secrets. What's coming up? What's being revealed? That's what the Scorpio moon is about. So what is coming up? And I guarantee you the truth is coming up. All right. So that's the interesting part about things, is that we're not in control, right? If we try to control things with ego, it's going to backfire. So we have to allow life to just kind of happen and allow things to come up and out the way that they need to. So that's what makes this moon so powerful, is people are kind of realizing that they can't hide anymore. They can't hide the truth. Things need to come up and out the way that they need to. And that's powerful expression for some people. So be mindful of what that means to you, because I'm almost feeling like people are kind of trying to tap into their intuition, but they may be a little bit confused. So maybe doing my workshop, if you live locally, will be helpful. I'll probably create that as an online option as well, where we would just kind of Skype one-on-one for that. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this. I found that like really helpful. Miracles are also coming up, meaning like it's okay to believe in miracles as well. When we do some of this type of work, it's amazing what we can see in people's healing experiences and how quickly energy can shift when we make conscious decisions and open ourselves up to those experiences. Okay, so just acknowledge that a lot can happen out of the blue. So cheers. I hope you guys have an awesome day. Take care. Bye.